Your Side follow-up, in June, we told you about a York County man who had to have his hands and feet amputated after becoming ill on Superbowl Sunday. Now, as medical reporter Susan Shapiro explains, Paul Miller is taking a huge step toward independence.
Paul Miller has been anxious for this day to come for months. The York County man who had his hands and feet amputated in February because of an infection is getting a high-tech prosthetic hand.
But they just couldn't get her soon enough. I wanted it like 2 days after I came out of the hospital.
Because Paul plans to return to work at his trucking company and hopefully get back on the road behind the wheel of a truck, the Office of Vocational Rehabilitation determined he was eligible for the $84,000 hand.
Are you at all back to work?
Rachel Wagner with the office says Paul is very motivated.
This has been a long time coming, and we've been able to help him, you know, in the process of getting back to work. So it's very exciting.
So this goes on in the exact same way that your other one went on?
Oh, that's pretty easy. Cool. All
right. Sarah Wooden of Ability Prosthetics and Orthotics slipped on the myoelectric hand that will allow Paul to do things he hasn't been able to do in months.
And up.
Cool.
And down. And up.
Well, you got it doing different stuff, lady.
Electrical impulses from Paul's own muscle movements are amplified and sent to a processor in the hand that controls the fingers and an opposable thumb, which moves to the palm of the hand.
Oh, it's a lot to learn, but it'll be well worth it.
Open.
Paul now has an app on his smartphone that has 24 different grip positions. It has Bluetooth connectivity. So watch what happens when I press the lateral grip. You see his hand move into that position.
There are two hands on the market now that have thumb opposition.
Sarah Wooden says this technology is as new as it gets.
So he has the opportunity to use it, experience it, become a master of his own universe.
There you go.
Look at this.
With his wife Shelley looking on.
That's amazing.
Paul practiced picking up small stones, stacking cones, and even writing his name on a mock-up Department of Motor Vehicles contract.
It'll be a huge step to independence. A huge step.
Paul and his wife Shelley have always enjoyed holding hands. And on this day, they finally got to rekindle that touch.
Yes, it took a little while, but my, it's great.
Waited for 7 months to do that. It's a good day.
It's like the best day ever. This is great.
And I can say the same.
Thank you.
I got to shake Paul's hand.
Thank you so much. That's great.
Susan Shapiro on Your Side, News 8.
There is a fundraiser for Paul to help with his medical expenses. It'll be held October 20th from 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. at Alfredo's Pizza in Hanover.